Hello, welcome to the Center for Parenting Education and our webcast called The Real Purpose of Discipline That Works. Understanding what you are trying to accomplish when you discipline your children can be a helpful guide to help you decide how you want to discipline and what type of discipline you want to use. In our podcast called Introduction to Discipline That Works, we said that the primary purpose of discipline should be to teach our children. Knowing this can guide you in deciding how to react to your children's misbehavior. You can consider what it is that they need to learn from the situation. For example, if your four-year-old son is hitting his younger brother when he gets angry, he may need to learn more appropriate ways to express his anger and frustration. In that first podcast, we also discussed the distinction between discipline and punishment, and we encouraged parents to use discipline, which is fair and respectful, is related to the offense, is consistent with the severity of the misbehavior. It encourages children to look inward to accept responsibility for what they did, and it teaches children internal control and self-discipline. Well, now you know that the main purpose of discipline is to teach your children, and that it is a healthier and more effective response than punishment. But you may wonder how you can check yourself to see that you are not being punitive. What are the specific goals you want to achieve when you discipline your children? You can see if by imposing discipline you're aiming to meet one of the following goals: restoring safety, calming down, reinforcing rules, teaching, and/or making amends. The first one that we'll talk about is restoring safety. The discipline or consequence establishes or reestablishes an emotional or physical environment of safety for each person.
For example, a parent takes a play hammer away from a four-year-old who is no longer using it on his workstation and is trying it out on other, more fragile items, like the coffee table, the kitty's tail, and a glass bowl. It is no longer safe for the house or for the kitty, for the child to play with it.
The next goal of discipline is calming down. The discipline or consequence provides an opportunity for all who might need time to calm down, regain composure, and be less emotional.
For example, the parent of the four-year-old this time takes the hammer away again, and when the child melts down, the parent calmly leads or carries the child to a timeout area, explaining that the child needs to work through his feelings until he's ready to talk about the situation. The parent may decide to sit with the child and even to hold the child on his lap until things stabilize.
The third goal of discipline can be to reinforce rules. In this case, the discipline or consequence makes it clear that a family has a rule that has been broken and needs to be reestablished or reinstated.
This time, as the mother takes the hammer away from the child, the parent of the four-year-old firmly states, "The rule in our family is no hitting. That includes kitties, coffee tables, and anything else in the house that might be broken or hurt."
The fourth goal of discipline is teaching. The discipline or consequence provides information that raises awareness, increases understanding, or clarifies values, responsibilities, or expectations.
This time, the parent explains to the child that things can get broken and animals hurt if they're hit with a hammer. We need to be careful with our things and treat the kitty gently. The parent asks the child, or helps the child, to come up with a plan for playing with the hammer in the future.
The final goal of discipline is making amends. The discipline or consequence provides ways for a child to correct something, which can include some form of restitution or fair payback that serves to correct and/or to restore a good relationship.
In this example, the child is required to find a fun game to play with the kitty, or to make a card that says, "I'm sorry," or find some other tangible gesture that allows the child to feel competent and capable of making things better. It doesn't matter that the kitty does not understand these gestures. It can help the child to feel like he is contributing in some way that makes amends.
Let's take a minute to see how these goals would play out in real life. An example that I'm going to give you states that 10-year-old Burton was playing in the yard when he decided to go to his friend's house. Although the rule in the family was that he is supposed to tell his mother or father before he leaves the house, he just left without notifying them. When the mother looked outside, he wasn't there, and she became worried.
An example of an unhealthy punishment would be that the mother goes to the friend's house, screams at Burden, and calls him irresponsible in front of his friend, and tells him that he cannot watch television for a month. This is not healthy or helpful response because the mother was disrespectful in calling him names, humiliated him in front of his friend, and the punishment was overly harsh and long and was unrelated to what Burden did wrong. A healthy goal of discipline in this situation would be one that teaches and reinforces rules. An example of that would be if Burden's father were to sit down with him and explain why it is important for him to tell his father where he's going and when, and that he gets worried and needs to know that Burden is safe, and that in their house people are courteous to one another by telling each other their plans. This is being respectful and courteous to one another. And as Burden's father teaches him the family values, the father can help Burden to come up with a plan for informing him of his plans or for asking permission to go somewhere. Another healthy goal of discipline would be to restore safety. In this case, Burden's mother is concerned about Burden's safety because of incidences in the neighborhood when children have been approached by strangers. She feels that Burden has not proven that he's able to abide by the rule in the house about letting her know if he leaves the property. She tells him that he now cannot go outside, even on their property, without checking with her first. If after a few days he's responsive and obeys this new rule, they can then discuss his being allowed to go outside the house without asking. As you can see from these examples, sometimes the discipline you impose will involve a number of different parts and can achieve a few of the five goals we outlined in this article. You can also see that there are many ways to handle any situation in a healthy and effective way. There's not just one right approach to disciplining your children. The specific discipline you use will depend on the situation, your child's age, maturity, and temperament.
In summary, when you discipline your children, your overall goal should be to teach your children how to behave appropriately. You can think to yourself, what does my child need to learn here? As you consider this, your discipline may teach them how to stay safe. It may reinforce rules so that they learn them. It may teach a value that's important to you. It may help your children learn to calm themselves, or it may give them a way to make amends so they learn that people make mistakes and can recover from them. It's helpful to keep in mind that even if you're striving to achieve one of these goals as you discipline your children, and you know that you're not being punitive, your children will most likely not appreciate your efforts and may have a very different view of the discipline you impose. You can expect some grumbling, unhappiness, or resistance. But if you know that you're working to achieve one of these goals, you can feel confident that you're teaching your children lessons that will help them to be successful in life. If you apply discipline in a respectful way, it can actually be a tool that you can use to build your child's self-esteem and maintain a healthy relationship. This positive relationship will make it more likely that your child will internalize your rules and values, thus helping them to become more independent in the long run. For more information about other aspects of effective discipline, check out our other on-demand articles on our website. For information about the Center for Parenting Education, you can visit the website as well. Thank you for joining us.